Hi dear audience, good day. A few weeks ago I had uploaded a scientific digital numerical analysis for the Ukrainian-Russian war with weight factors for the probabilities or the factors affecting win and loss in each country. And concluded that Russia is in the numbers, is a bit more. But today I am going to make a discussion in regards of this digital research. I am feeling very, very sorry for what's going on in this war. The Ukrainians are fighting very bravely, defending their country, their families, their lands. A small country is fighting very bravely, a strong country, greater in number, higher in technology. And in spite of all this, Russia is giving very fake excuses to its aggressions and attack to Ukraine. As exactly as she did in the past with Finland on 1934, and as she did in Czechoslovakia in 1968, I think, or 69, and as she did in all the Eastern Europe in the Second World War, when defeated Hitler and when the Russian army marched occupying all the Eastern European countries, Finland, Poland, Romania, Lithuania, Estonia, and kept them under his authority till the fall of the Soviet Union in the 90s, and moved on till it occupied half of Germany. That's another story. The East Germany and the West Germany, the Germany divided into two nations. When the Eastern Germany citizens endangered their lives, climbing between East Germany to West Germany during the cut-off of the high voltage current of the cables passing between East Germany and West Germany, they climbed the high voltage in case of current cut-off, in spite of the possibility of the current returning during their climbing. They try and some escaped and some failed. They were trying to escape from the Eastern Germany under the Russian authority or regime to the Western Germany and escape from slavery to freedom. A long story to prove how bad the Russian regime, how cruel they rule countries under their authorities. What I remember now is President Sadat once saying in one of his speeches, no one has dignity can accept the Russian behavior. Anyhow, what I am sorry for is that in spite of the fake excuses Russia is giving to its invasion to Ukraine, passed in 2014, when it occupied the Crimea, now with the excuse that Ukraine is going to join the NATO. What's the matter? What's the difference between Ukraine and any of the European countries? By the modern weapons, this distance of the Western Europe or the Ukraine being at the border of Russia, it doesn't make difference at all. The speeds are terrific of weapons. Doesn't make difference. It's an expensive behavior of the Russians. It's a Russian gene, rather. Not regime, gene. The Russian gene is expensive, aggressive. Cannot say less. And the other thing to make me sorry for this small nation, brave, with brave people, by the time they would not be able to resist the Russian attack. Why? The Russians are punching under the belt. They mean to destroy the Ukrainian people's psychology. They are attacking the infrastructure to make the Ukrainian people in this cold live in the dark, without water, without electricity, in this cold, without heating. It's a real cruel deed. In addition, many, especially America, is trying to withdraw its military equipment assistance to Ukraine. At this very critical time, America and some of the Western Europe countries are drawing their hands from or decreasing its military supplies to Ukraine. They think they are far from the Russian danger. No, they are not far. Once past ago, after the one of the Europeans and the Americans over Hitler in the Second World War, all the German leaders were tried, and one of the German top military leaders, namely Göring, said something. It's a prophecy, and I think he was very wise. He said to the American court head, the Bolsheviks would murder you one day. And this is about to happen. America thinks, and Western Europe, they are far from the Russian danger. No, they are not far. Russia is a very dangerous, expensive country, and it would reach them one day and reach the American coast and attack the Americans. It's a Russian gene, rather. And if the Ukrainians give up, I would not blame them. Their psychology is decaying and falling down by time. No electricity for the civilians, and the military forces are part of the civil people and civilians. And Russia also, in spite of its big population and its military personnel being nearly four times that of the Ukrainian army, is confronted. That's not enough. Russia is not able to face the Ukrainians with all this. She is confronted and make use of the Chechen and the Wagner mercenaries, and even the Wagner mercenaries are calling for new volunteers. The Chechen, the Belarusia, actually the Chechen, the Belarusia, the Wagner mercenary company, military mercenary company, in addition to the Russians. Four nations against a small country. Really, the Ukrainians are brave. We hope them to win. But I doubt that very much, in spite of the retreat of the Europeans and the Americans from supplying them with equipment. They don't supply them with personnel, but another remark is that I think that many of the Eastern European countries are giving Ukraine weapons, military equipment, sorry. While the Europeans, Western Europe and America is withdrawing and retreating from supplying Ukraine. Why the Eastern Europe? Because they have suffered so much from the Russian authorities, and while they were under its occupation from Russia. Very sorry to find this, to find Ukraine reaching this condition. And the world don't feel the Russian danger. The Russian, I don't say wolf bear, it's the Russian werewolf. Okay, I hope the world wakes up before it's too late. Okay, good one.